नमस्कार। टुडे वी विल कवर रिब्स, इट्स जनरल फीचर्स एंड सम अटैचमेंट्स ऑफ रिब्स विथ इट्स अप्लाइड इम्पोर्टेंस। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज रिब? रिब इज अ फ्लैट लाइक बोन और प्लेट लाइक फ्लैट बोन। नाउ इट इज एलॉन्गेटेड एंड स्लाइटली ट्विस्टेड एट सम पॉइंट्स। नाउ रिब्स आर टोटल इन नंबर 12, और कैन से 12 पेयर्स ऑफ रिब्स प्रेजेंट इन थोरेसिक केज। मीन्स थोरेसिक केज इज फॉर्म बाय 12 पेयर्स ऑफ रिब्स, एंड इन दीज 12 पेयर्स ऑफ रिब्स देयर आर सम रिब्स विच आर सिमिलर इन फीचर्स, बट सम रिब्स आर हैविंग स्पेशल फीचर्स और डिफरेंट फीचर्स, एंड वी कैन क्लासीफाई बेस ऑन दीज इन टू टू टाइप्स ऑफ रिब्स। बट बिफोर दिस आई वॉन्ट टू कवर सम एडिशनल पॉइंट्स विच ट्रू रिब्स एंड फॉल्स रिब्स। वॉट इज ट्रू रिब? रिब नंबर 1-7 आर ट्रू रिब्स, एंड रिब नंबर 8-12 आर फॉल्स रिब्स। वॉट इज ट्रू रिब? अ ट्रू रिब, इट इज कनेक्टेड विथ बोथ वर्टेब्रा एंड स्टर्नम, with sternum with the help of costal cartilage. Now these are true ribs, means rib number 1 to rib number 7, these are true ribs. But false ribs, these are connected with vertebra, but these are not directly connected with sternum, with or without help of cartilage. Now in these false ribs, ribs number 8-12, these out of these 8-12, rib number 8, 9, and 10, these are connected with sternum indirectly with the help of its costal cartilages. Costal cartilages of rib number 8, 9, 10 joins with each other and form one costal ridge, or you can say costal border, continuous costal border. In relation with this, there is formation, and this costal margin above joins with costal cartilage of seventh rib, and in this way it indirectly get connected with sternum. In true ribs, what happens? First to seventh ribs are true ribs. These true ribs are connected with sternum with the help of its costal cartilage. Therefore, these are vertebrosternal ribs. But 8, 9 and 10th, these are indirectly connected with sternum, but anterior ends of 8, 9th and 10th ribs are connected with this sternum indirectly with the help of its cartilage after joining, after forming costal margin. These are costochondral ribs. Now remaining two ribs, last 11th and 12th, these two ribs are having no direct connection with sternum, with or without costal cartilage. What happens? These two ribs having lateral ends, and these lateral ends of 11th and 12th rib are present in the muscle mass of back, covered by costal cartilage, or you can say simply it is capped by cartilage. Therefore, these last two ribs are not having any connection with sternum. Therefore, out of these 12 ribs, true ribs are 1-7, false ribs are 8-12. Now, last two ribs also, 11 and 12th, also known as floating ribs, because there is no connection of these ribs with sternum. These are also known as, therefore, floating ribs. In addition to these 12 ribs, there is presence of cervical rib above and lumbar rib below. What is cervical rib? Cervical rib, what happens in transverse process of 7 cervical vertebra? There is formation of abnormal rib, and this is known as cervical rib, and this cervical rib is connected with this first strip with the help of some fibrous bands. And these fibrous band may compress important structure in relation with this first strip or above first strip, which lower trunk of brachial plexus, subclavian artery, and it may cause compression effects of these, causing pain in upper limb, also occlusion of the subclavian artery. Now lowermost lumbar type of rib. In addition to 12 rib, first lumbar vertebra, its transverse process get elongated and it looks like a rib. It is known as lumbar rib. Now in addition to these, out of 12 ribs, some ribs shows same features. These are known as typical ribs. Which ribs are typical rib having similar features? These are 3 to 9. And atypical ribs. Now remaining ribs are atypical ribs having different features. Which are atypical ribs? 1, 2, 10, 11, 12, means 1st, 2nd, 10th, 11th, and 12th ribs are atypical ribs having different features. Now we'll see features of typical ribs. Which features present in typical rib? Typical ribs shows two ends, sternal end and vertebral end. Sternal end and vertebral end. Sternal end is anterior end, which shows articulation with the sternum with the help of its costal cartilage. Vertebral end is posterior end, and this posterior end articulate with this body of thoracic vertebra and its transverse process. Then in between these two ends there is presence of shaft. Now which features visible in sternal end? Sternal end, it is anterior end. It shows concave facet, and this concave facet articulates with its costal cartilage, and this costal cartilage now then articulates with this sternum. Posterior end, which one is known as vertebral end, it shows three parts: head, neck and tubercles. In tubercles again two parts, articular part and non-articular part. Head articulates with body of vertebra, but in relation with this head there is presence of two separate facets, and in between these two facets, upper facet and lower facet, there is presence of crest, a sharp margin. Now this crest or sharp margin shows attachment with intervertebral disc with the help of one ligament. Now upper and lower facet. Lower facet articulate with respective thoracic vertebra, same number thoracic vertebra, but upper facet articulate with the body of upper thoracic vertebra. Then from this head, neck starts. Neck goes posteriorly, backward and laterally, and up to tubercles of rib. In relation with this tubercle, or in between head and tubercles, this neck shows anterior surface, posterior surface, upper margin and lower margin. Just lateral to this neck there is presence of tubercles. Tubercles again divided into two parts, articular part and non-articular part. Articular part of tubercle articulates with facet present in relation with transverse process of same vertebra. Non-articular part not having any articulation with transverse process. Then from tubercle starts shaft. Shaft goes backward laterally, and here there is a sharp angulation or curve formation in relation with the shaft, and there is formation of one angle, posterior angle, and this posterior angle is posterior most part in relation with thoracic cage, and this point is posterior most point if you compare posterior most point in relation with thoracic spine. Therefore, because of this angle, in human or human can lie in prone position, because these angle, posterior angles of ribs are posterior most points in thoracic cage. Therefore, there is no problem of this thoracic spines. And because of this again posterior angle, there is formation of paravertebral gutters inside thoracic cage in this inner aspect of rib. Here again, after formation of posterior angle, shaft goes anteriorly, and in relation with the shaft there is presence of outer surface, inner surface, upper border, lower border. Which features visible in relation with this surfaces and borders? Upper border shows inner lip and outer lip, while lower border shows one costal groove, and this costal grooves having upper margin and lower margin. Lower margin is sharp, upper margin is present in relation with upper aspect of costal groove, and this upper margin continue posteriorly in relation with neck of rib, forming its lower margin or lower border. This costal groove contains neurovascular bundle, intercostal nerve, artery and vein. These structures present in between, or neurovascular bundle present in between intercostal muscles. But which intercostal muscles? Intercostal is intimus and internal intercostal. These neurovascular bundle present. Now here, attachment in relation with this costal groove. Upper margin of costal groove gives origin to this intercostalis intimus. Floor of this costal groove gives origin to intercostalis internus or internal intercostal muscle. Now lowermost sharp margin of this rib gives origin to external intercostal muscle. This is about lower part. Now upper margin, upper border, it shows two lips, outer lip, inner lip. Outer lip shows insertion of external intercostal muscle. Inner lip shows insertion of these two muscles. Which two muscles? Internal intercostal and intercostalis intimus muscle. These are insertions. Now outer surface and inner surface of this typical rib. In relation with posterior aspect of this rib near neck or after tubercle, it shows one oblique line which will go downward, and this line will give attachment to thoracolumbar fascia. Now continue, outer surface of these ribs, anterior part, again it will show one oblique line, and in relation with this oblique line, anterior part shows attachment of one muscle of abdomen, external oblique muscle of abdomen. Posterior to this, in upper typical ribs, upper eight ribs, there is attachment of serratus anterior muscle, and below that there is attachment of latissimus dorsi muscle. Now anterior end of this ribs, it is concave in shape, and this concave shape articulates with its costal cartilage, same costal cartilage, and with the help of this costal cartilage, this rib articulates with sternum. This is about typical rib. Now atypical rib. In atypical rib, first rib, it is a flat short rib, and this rib shows head, neck, tubercle, but costal groove is absent. There is no costal groove in relation with first rib. Then neurovascular bundle? Yes, it is present in relation with lower surface. In first rib, there is presence of lower surface, upper surface, inner border, outer border. See, there is difference in between the surfaces and borders of first rib and typical rib. In first rib, outer border, inner border, upper surface, lower surface. In relation with lower surface of this first rib, there is presence of this neurovascular bundle. In between internal intercostal muscle and pleura of lung, because intimus muscle is absent in first rib. Now, upper surface of this first rib shows features in which near to this inner border there is presence of one sharp tubercle known as scalene tubercle, and this scalene tubercle shows attachment of scalenus anterior muscle. Now, anterior to and posterior to this scalenus tubercle there is presence of groove. Now, in relation with this groove, anterior groove, there is presence of subclavian vein, and in posterior groove there is presence of subclavian artery along with one nerve which lower trunk of brachial plexus. Now, in relation with attachment of this upper surface, anterior part of this first rib gives attachment to costoclavicular ligament and subclavius muscle. Now, posterior to this scalene tubercle, there is presence of or attachment of scalenus medius muscle. Posterior to posterior groove. Now, outer margin shows origin of first digitation of serratus anterior muscle. Inner border of first rib, it gives attachment to suprapleural membrane, or you can say Simpson's fascia. Now, this is about first rib. How to identify first rib? Side determination. First rib is a flat, small. If you put this first rib on a flat surface, if side is right, what will happen? Both ends, anterior end and posterior end, will touch to surface. But if side is wrong, what will happen? Anterior end will go up. This is used for identification of side of first rib. Now, second rib. Second rib, it is twice as compared to the length of first rib. It is again having head, neck, tubercles, articulation with the second thoracic vertebra. Here, surfaces are again different. It shows upper margin, lower margin, or upper border, lower border, outer surface, inner surface. But direction of outer surface is upward and outward. Inner surface faces downward and medially. This is about surface direction of second rib. Second rib shows one prominent tubercle in relation with its margin, and this tubercle shows origin of second digitation of serratus anterior muscle. Posterior to this tubercle, there is attachment of scalenus posterior and serratus posterior superior muscle. This is about second rib. Now, last three ribs, 10, 11 and 12. 10, 11. These two ribs, 10, 11. 10th rib, it shows head, neck, tubercles, costal groove, but length is less. 11th rib. In 11th rib, head, neck present, then tubercle also present. Costal groove is present only in posterior part of this rib. Again, length is less. 12th rib, there is no neck, no tubercle, no costal groove in 12th rib. All these three ribs articulate with respective vertebra, body of respective vertebra 10, 11 and 12. Now in relation with 12th rib, as 11th and 12th ribs are floating ribs, therefore lateral ends of these two ribs present in muscle mass covered by or capped by cartilage. Now in 12th rib, it shows again difference, it shows anterior surface, posterior surface, upper border, lower border. Anterior surface shows attachment of caudatus lumborum medially, and laterally there is attachment of diaphragm and transversus abdominis muscle. In relation with this caudatus lumborum, upper and lower margin shows attachment of thoracolumbar fascia. Posterior surface of this 12th rib shows attachment of some muscles from mediolaterally, which levator costi, longissimus, thoracis, iliocostalis. Then lateral part of this posterior surface shows attachment of latissimus dorsi, serratus posterior, inferior and external oblique muscle of abdomen. This is about attachment on 12th rib. Now as you know, now there are total number of 12 ribs or 12 pairs of ribs. Anterior end of ribs are slightly lower in position as compared to posterior end of rib. Therefore, this is prominently visible in first rib. If you compare anterior end and posterior end position, now in relation with oblique position of ribs, as lower position of anterior end of rib, there is obliquity of rib, and this oblique position increases from first to ninth rib, and after that there is less oblique in position, or lower ribs are less oblique in position, and this position, obliquity of these ribs, is essential for respiratory movements. During inspiration there is increase in antero-posterior diameter as well as transverse diameter, and for this oblique position of ribs is required. Now something about applied aspect. In applied aspect of these ribs, fracture. Bone is a rib, therefore fracture is common. Fracture by direct injury and fracture by indirect injury or compression fracture. If fracture is by direct injury, what will happen? The fracture ends will go in and it will cause injury to pleura, causing pneumothorax and hemothorax, and condition is painful. But compression injury causes fracture near posterior angle of rib, and fracture end goes outward, faces outwards. Then flail chest. What is flail chest? If fracture at two or more points, what will happen? If fracture is more than one rib, two ribs, three ribs, more ribs, and points of fracture are more than two in each rib, what will happen? It will form a separate segment of that fractured rib. During inspiration, there is movement of this segment. What will happen? This fracture segment will go in during inspiration and it will come out during expiration, therefore causing difficulty in breathing. Next condition is stow in chest. If there is fracture of costal cartilages near to this sternum, what will happen? This fracture present on both side of sternum, what will happen? Sternum will go in and it cannot come out, and such type of injury is common in vehicular accident, four wheeler accident, and in this difficulty in respiration. Now next is thoracotomy. In thoracotomy, opening of thoracic cavity for any purpose, mainly for removal of pus. For this thoracotomy, there is one approach, सब पेरियोस्टियल रिसेक्शन ऑफ रिब इज डन एंड थ्रू द फ्लोर ऑफ दिस पेरियोस्टियम इन रिलेशन विद दिस रिब वी कैन एंटर इन साइड थोरेसिक कैविटी फॉर रिमूवल ऑफ पस. देन आफ्टर रिमूवल रिब कैन रीजेनरेट इजिली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंस ऑफ पेरियोस्टियम. देर इज नो नीड फॉर सेपरेट प्रोसीजर फॉर दिस. अगेन दीज सब पेरियोस्टियल रिसेक्शन कैन बी यूज फॉर बोन ग्राफ्टिंग मेनली आफ्टर सर्जरीज ऑफ मैंडिबल कार्सिनोमा ऑफ मैंडिबल. वी कैन यूज सेगमेंट्स ऑफ रिब फॉर रिकंस्ट्रक्टिव सर्जरीज ऑफ मैंडिबल. नाउ दिस इज ऑल अबाउट रिब्स इट्स अप्लाइड एनाटॉमी. थैंक यू.